Hi, this is Ben Finio with Science Buddies, and this video will show you how to assemble your Maglev train. To start, take your wooden block and two short magnetic strips. Peel the paper backing off the magnetic strips and then put them on the edge of one side of the block. Press down firmly, and they should stick to the wood. Make sure you line them up straight and that they don't stick over the edge of the wood. If you mess up, you can peel them off and put them back on, but try not to do this too many times as they will lose their stickiness. Next, cut off one of the long sides of the cardboard box. Take your wooden block of the train and the two plastic angle pieces from your kit and clear double-sided tape, which you need to supply separately. Your goal will be to attach the plastic angle pieces so they are facing outward and form guide rails for the train to prevent it from tipping over. So you can take the wooden block, use it as a spacer in between the angles, and move them out a little bit more so there's about a millimeter of space. This will make sure that the train can slide back and forth without getting stuck between the angles. Next, take the two long magnetic strips from the kit, and you're going to attach these parallel to each other in between the plastic angles. You'll want these strips to be slightly closer together than the strips in the bottom of your train, as this will help the train balance. Now, these are a little harder to apply because they're long and rather flexible. So put one down first, a couple millimeters in from the plastic angle. And again, if you mess up, you can peel these off and reattach them. Just try not to do that too many times, as they will gradually lose their stickiness. But you could also use clear double-sided tape if the built-in tape starts to lose its stickiness too much. Now, there's something to watch out for. These strips will try to attract to each other since they're long and flexible, so you have to hold the second one off to the side as you put it in. And then once you have both strips pressed down, test your train. Put the train in between the angles, and it should be able to slide back and forth easily without getting stuck. A good way to test is just to give the train a flick with your finger, and it should glide easily down the track before it coasts to a stop. If it gets stuck right away, that means your angles are too close together and causing too much friction on the train. If your train tilts to one side, like this, then your angles are probably too far apart. That's allowing too much wobble room for the train than allowing one of the magnets to pull it down like that. So look at your train from the end. It should float nice and parallel to the tracks. If it doesn't, if it's crooked, you can move your angles together a little bit to help keep it upright. You can also move your long magnet rails either a little closer together or a little farther apart to help the balance. So you can tweak all of those things and use fresh tape as necessary as it loses its stickiness. One final test is you can hold your entire track at an angle and the train could glide down easily without getting stuck, and then you are ready to move on and do your experiment. For thousands of other science or engineering projects for school or at home, visit us online at www.sciencebuddies.org.